Thousands of frustrated residents in Sydney are now entering their sixth day without power.
Tracy Burke and her neighbours Paul and Greg join us now from their street in Hornsby Heights. Tracy, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Now, there are 30 children in your street and it's been nearly a week now without power. How are you coping?
I think I'm managing, but I'm not so sure about my neighbours with small kids and newborn babies. It's been such a challenge. No customer service, live wires on the street up until yesterday. It's so disappointing and so frustrating.
Did you say live wires on the street until yesterday? It was what, 5 or 6
yes.
days after?
Yes. Yes, exactly.
So, Paul, you had live wires on your street. You've got kids
yes.
walking up and down the street. Just tell us, I mean, for you guys, what's that like?
Yeah, so Sunday afternoon, we had 2 massive trees falling on the wires. The firemen came and blocked the street till the night. Then they left, and they just left some tape and basically live wire with 330 volt. On the ground, anyone touching the trees could have basically been electrocuted.
So you had to explain this, I guess, to all the kids that, basically not to go outside.
That's right.
Yeah, that's right. We were pretty isolated. We couldn't really leave our houses. I think someone from Ausgrid said that the wires were not live, that they'd been cut. And then we found out a couple of days later that they were, when there'd been children, you know, walking past them to go to school.
You think about what could have happened, right?
Oh, it's frightening.
You think about also the fact that you haven't been communicated with, obviously. Ausgrid haven't communicated with you.
Yep,
and the fact
yep.
that, I mean, do you allow yourself to think what could have happened?
Well, you can't not think about it. You know, it's fantastic that nothing did happen, but still, I mean, there's a big level of trust has been lost with Ausgrid because they say one thing and they don't do what they say they're going to do. And also too, because there's been no communication and there's no customer service. I mean, they're quick to send an email to say thanks that, you know, you want your bill to be by email, not paper, the day after you've paid your electricity bill. But, you know, where's the service when we really need them?
Well, Tracy and Paul, it's a frustration and anger, I think, shared by many people this morning. We've got Ausgrid's Chief Operations Officer on the program in about an hour's time. Do you have a message for him?
Yeah, what we want to tell him is he has a duty of care and so has the state government because they sold the company privately. Basically, I know a lot of Ausgrid employees. They do an amazing job, as in the crews are just overworked. There's just not enough people. Like on Sunday and Monday, there were like, I don't know, 300 or 500 jobs on the North Shore. But the duty of care is you cannot have live wire anywhere for more than, I don't know, 12 hours, 24 hours. Total lack of care.
And to, you know, they said that we're a priority, and we know that there are so many priorities, but, you know, what does the word priority actually mean?
Tracy, tell us how you really feel.
Angry.
Angry and frustrated, like you wouldn't believe.
All right. Well, we'll leave it there.
Imagine if one child... I'm sorry.
No, you complete what you were about to say. That's exactly what we'll need to hear.
Yeah, sorry. Imagine if one child or one adult had been electrocuted. That there would be so much trouble, and it would be unbelievable that in our very advanced economy we can't deal with those matters better. And it's going to keep happening. You know, we've had 3 major electrical cuts here in the last 8 months.
All right, very well said. Thank you for that. And we'll put all that to Ausgrid. You are putting up with stuff that no Australian family should have to. It's a near thing. We'll put all those things to Ausgrid in the next hour. Thanks for your time today. Appreciate it and good luck.